Some patients with untreated streptococcal pharyngitis develop acute rheumatic fever, which can result in lifelong rheumatic heart disease. In recent decades, the incidence of rheumatic fever has declined dramatically in higher-income countries, owing to the treatment of streptococcal infections. The implementation of World Health Organization guidelines has also led to reductions in the incidence of rheumatic heart disease in many other countries. What then is the current global burden of rheumatic heart disease? As part of the 2015 Global Burden of Disease study, investigators used multiple sources of data, including vital statistics registries, the published medical literature, and administrative data sets, and then employed epidemiologic modeling techniques to estimate the global, regional, and national prevalence of rheumatic heart disease, as well as death rates and disability-adjusted life years attributable to it from 1990 to 2015. During that period, the global age-standardized death rate from rheumatic heart disease decreased from 9.2 per 100,000 to 4.8 per 100,000, a change of 47.8%. The age-standardized prevalence of rheumatic heart disease declined significantly in several regions. In 2015, the estimated age-standardized prevalence was 444 per 100,000 in countries with endemic disease and 3.4 per 100,000 in non-endemic countries. The highest rates of age-standardized death due to rheumatic heart disease, prevalence of rheumatic heart disease, and disability-adjusted life years due to rheumatic heart disease were in Oceania, South Asia, and Central Sub-Saharan Africa. The investigators conclude that the health-related burden of rheumatic heart disease has declined in most countries, but the condition persists in some of the world's poorest regions. Full study results are available at NEJM.org.